I'm afraid to fly. That's how out of shape I am now. Everybody fights to get on an airplane. Try to be first on the plane, not me. You know what I try to do? I try to be the last guy on the plane. Because I think, how much cooler is that than being the first guy up there who's sitting there in first class, waiting, sipping his little mimosa, doing Sudoku? Instead, 30 minutes later, I walk on, I'm like, hey, thanks for waiting, chief, but tell the pilot Matt Eisman has arrived. Now we can fire up this jet and let's go.
He does stand-up.
We're in the same shirt.
Does ninja... No, listen, it's all right when you come down to the same shirt because things may not necessarily be going really well in your career. And you have a limited wardrobe, right?
Thank you, Pat. Thank you for making me feel better about my wardrobe choice.
Matt Eisman, the only person who has done Cho-Cho-San in Madame Butterfly. I think it may be one of the few things that you haven't done.
No.
You really do have a fun life with a variety.
It's been great. Yeah, it's, you know, it really has been, to me, I look back on, you know, I started out life obviously going towards medicine, and then, and you think you know where your life is going, and then you end up taking a complete right turn, and now I'm out here doing stand-up comedy. We're heading into season 11 of American Ninja Warrior, and I get to work with one of my idols, Arnold Schwarzenegger. These things that are just, I never thought would be a part of my life, but because you make this choice, you make a right turn, and you decide to do something different.
Let's see, American Ninja Warriors saving lives.
I know.
In the operating
When you put it
room.
Like that, you sound like my parents going, why would you choose that?
Your dad, a famed medical specialist, right?
Yeah.
And yet he encouraged you to go into comedy.
I think there were two things about it. One, I think he understood medicine was changing and that it really is a calling. And he was a firm believer that if you don't hear this calling, by all means, you know, pursue something else because you won't be happy with medicine. But the other thing I think he saw was just, he's like, look, you're my son. I want you to be happy. And that's, I know how fortunate I am to have parents who were supportive. To my face, Pat. I can't imagine what my dad said behind my back.
Okay, Matt Eisman, though, you're going to be making a choice tonight at the House of Comedy.
Yes.
Through the weekend. Medicine laughs.
I'm hoping laughs. If anybody, I actually had someone that was at the Laugh Factory, that video they showed. I had someone collapse during a show I was hosting. And
is there a doctor?
I had to, and so I go up to this guy, and I'm assessing him, and I'm realizing, oh my God, it's been a while since I've done medicine. But then I realized quickly he was just drunk and had passed out. So I just had to drag him out of the room. And fortunately, I'm large enough that I can be a body dragger and let him get out of there.
American Ninja Warrior is certainly one of the faces over how many years?
Well, this is season 11. It's my 10th year.
Okay.
Arizona has some of our great competitors, guys like Adam Rail and Rebecca Bonilla.
But did you ever? Did you ever, when the cameras were off?
Are you setting me up here?
Because
this is what's awful. Of course, I've tried the course, and I've broken my foot and broken my ankle, and I've now been banned from attempting obstacles because they said, look, clearly you're not a ninja, and we actually don't want you to get any more hurt because we need you talking about the people who can do it.
All right, but you look like a jock. Did you go out for anything at Princeton?
Yeah, I played baseball all 4 years. I was on the varsity team, and we won the league. I got to be pitching. That was my Super Bowl moment, playing baseball at Princeton. It's a little bit like being on the chess team at the University of Miami. It's not exactly what they're known for, but it was fun. It was a great experience.
Was it a full ride, though, the scholarship?
We don't have athletic scholarships in the Ivy League. So I did get offered. I got offered a scholarship to Stanford. They offered to pay for my books. Would have been a couple hundred dollars here.
Matt Eisman
makes me look petite.
I came in just means I got to lose some weight. Thanks, Matt.
Solid.
No, that's
good. How do you think it makes me feel?
Well, yeah, so Matt, you wouldn't want to work with me.
Why?
Well, I'm just saying, since I'm so big, right?
No,
would you?
I work with Akbar Bajabiamila, who's 6'6", 260, and has a six-pack.
Yeah.
So I'm used to being around people who make me feel like I really need to lose weight and work out.
Would you work with us like this?
Yeah. I love this. This place is so
like
much
this.
Fun. Like this?
Oh, you mean the prep time. This is how we do
it. What is this?
Is working in the office to prepare for the show.
Yeah, what do you think of that?
Those are ninja moves right there.
Can I be on the show?
Look at the bunny hop.
You totally attracted that.
See?
I feel like I should get some singles out right now and tip this man, because those were the moves.
He paid for my lunch.
Matt Eisman, House of Comedy, through the weekend. He may be singing Madame Butterfly.
I do.
Because you never know.
Can I add, by the way, I am going to be, my shows, I'm going to be raising money to help Danielle Williams, who I met through Arizona Mix, and who is a dear friend. So, Diva, be strong. We're going to be laughing in your honor.